From my perspective, China is clearly using this test to convey a number of messages. I would say the first message relates to how the missile flew, the trajectory of the missile. So if you look at the missile, it was launched from Hainan, China's, I guess, equivalent of Florida. And then it flew in between, over the waters in between the Philippines and Taiwan. And then it landed some almost 12,000 kilometers further from that in the Pacific, as you mentioned. And that trajectory, I think, was meant from China's perspective to convey a number of signals, including to the Philippines, to Taiwan, and to the United States. I'm happy to elaborate if you want to discuss any of the specific messages that China may have intended to convey.
Well, speaking of messages, I mean, is it largely about deterrence, or is there more to it than that?
I think it's definitely largely deterrence, but it's also maybe particular given some of the recent developments in the region. So, for example, with the Philippines, we know that China has been objecting to U.S. deployment of a mid-range missile system to northern Philippines, the Typhoon missile system, and the Chinese trajectory of its most recent ICBM test is quite close to northern Philippines. So I think that's one message that China is trying to convey to the Philippines and the United States: please remove your missiles. And China's using a missile flight of its own to demonstrate that. Also, we know that in the past year or two, that China's the PLA Rocket Force, the unit responsible for managing, as well as in this case, testing China's missiles, has been under a lot of internal pressure, that has had corruption scandals and various other issues, including reporting in the United States that some of its missiles were filled with water. I think that's false reporting, but lots of allegations of how incompetent it is. So it is in China's interest to also demonstrate its military capabilities to the United States and to the international community at large.
去年还是前年年底吧，大陆也是从西北的时候发射一个导弹打到南海去。国际媒体一声，这好像也没什么事，为什么？因为打到南海哈，就是标准了，不针对任何国家。这够清楚了吧？你总不能说啊，这个中国没事干，要打一颗导弹哦，继续打越南吧，或打柬埔寨吧？没这回事吧？他就是试射给美国航空母舰看。 你进入我南海，那你要这么嚣张，你给我垫垫垫垫看，对不对？好，可以讲真的是不针对任何国家，可是射向夏威夷，你会觉得这个不针对任何国家吗？就是针对美国嘛，所以美国相关的媒体才会一下子把它当大新闻的报道嘛，
炸锅了。
对啊。而且不是只有美国啊，英国啊，对啊，他们想说，哎呦，这个老大哥有人来挑战了，哎，比如说帅将军啊，若他的枪械给我看，我就说我带兄弟来，韩明兄，你脱衣给他看，哇，身上好几把机关枪，就是个道理嘛。就是美国就是在想一想哦，前一段时间会不会秀肌肉秀过头了？中国的闷声不响嘛，现在整件完了以后，他也秀给你看嘛，就是大家互相在。 比赛这个秀肌肉，然后问题是美国跟他的盟友们就会很紧张啊，哎呦，那我老大都不一定哦，到时候会挺我们哦，为什么？因为我们老大自己也在别人的洲际导弹的攻击范围哦，
对，
所以他到时候真的要听我们，那我们以后对中国大陆这么像的汪汪叫，要不要大可以敢大声一点吗？大概就不至于了吧？
是，
这某种程度有一种较量跟威慑的作用啊。 那帕帕罗啦，帕帕罗，你也秀一下肌肉吧，对不对？看你有多少肌肉可以秀嘛。
是，
对呀。对，所以我是觉得这个东西啊，能够坐下来谈是好事啦，啊，那坐下来商量也是好事。但是如果说一方面坐下来谈，美国又秀肌肉，你就叫中国乖乖的不秀肌肉。那北京整天跟中国老百姓每一年收税收那么多，他能跟中国老百姓交代吗？中国老百姓问说，哎。 北京，我今年广东已经缴了多少税了？你怎么这不闷被人家这样叫嚣欺负你的闷声不响啊？也会有这种疑问嘛？所以北京也要给老百姓做个交代吧。哎呀，你看看，他们在耀武扬威，我们稍微放个鞭炮给他看。朋友都知道我是很挑剔的，防晒乳我选 KS
皇家呵护抗光清爽高防晒凝露，因为它有媲美蓝光神盾的炸藻植萃。 保护我在阳光下延缓肌肤老化，维持青春弹力。
可以防御工作环境里的3C 商品、各种光源对肌肤的伤害，擦起来清爽不黏腻。我特别喜欢它做到海洋友善，365天天天抗光抗老化是我的保养日常。你呢？呵护您，呵护全家人，专属你的 KS Royal Care 抗光清爽高防晒凝露。